Imperial.
The Ravens were up ahead.
Oh my. Really, nothing out of these jars. I don't know if that's just because of loot or what.
Rather wanted one for his house.
Ow! When did you get your exclamation mark saying that you were going to attack me? Didn't even see that. He just swung out. I whacked him a few times, went after his one buddy behind me, and then he just smashed me. Jesus. Renardo is getting stronger, but I'm not getting any better. Lots of energy. Sweet. Shieldbreaker level 3.
Renardo felt wrong all over. He could feel an almost palpable sickness in the air.
Maybe it's because he could use a little bit of health.
They would look like these monstrous crystals. The forest was quieter than it had been. There were insects, a few birds, if you didn't count the ravens. Renardo smelled sick animals and dying ones, but no healthy ones. And getting a bad feeling about this, Renardo thought. Maybe Lupin
wrong sword.
Right. Maybe they should have kidnapped Zenobia instead
or,
of coming here.
I guess not. Huh.
Of course there was a puzzle. You couldn't expect the transcendent emperor to bury a god's eye in a leather sack where anyone could pick it up.
Wait, can I? Oh, wait. Like, can I dash through that? No, I don't need to dash through that. I just need to hit the proper switch. Silly, silly boy. And what did that just do? Oh, no? Well, I'll flip that back.
This couldn't be good for global warming.
No skill points, about 3 more fights if I do want to get one of those. I guess any sword will open up a hero door. I thought I would have to have my hero sword. Get rid of that damn buffin bird. That thing is awful for my survival rate. Well, that went relatively well. And I'm at the core already. So how is this going to work with,
As he held the radiant icosahedron, Renardo felt
with Lupino.
Like dozens of tiny worms were nibbling his insides. It wasn't healthy to be so close to the eye of a god.
How could
he use it? He could take it to the observatory. The scientists there could tell him how to harness its ancient power. But honestly, Renardo ached to get away from it. He brought the core back with him to the Farfarer.
Ooh, that thing seems
honestly
to have a very negative effect without
Renardo
its,
to be rid of it.
Exterior
tell
to
you what,
it.
Said Lupino. I'll take it to the observatory. You attack the Imperial outpost.
No, I need to go see the nerds. I've been avoiding the nerds.
The Imperial outpost is a vital communications node. Taking it could shatter the Empire's ability to coordinate. And it would be full of secret plans and maps and maybe even rebel prisoners.
Rebel prisoners?
It was a good target for a hero like Renardo.
Yeah, but I already went after that one. I had the Sky Ripper.
This was a ruse so that Lupino could get the core into the hands of the Empire. Was Renardo ready to take that risk?
No. Exclamation. So I haven't gone through either of these routes.
Himself.
I think I'm going to go to the scientists this time. Although, would this be specific enough that I... Renardo could really rely on Lupino to bring it to the observatory. No, it was too risky. He would have to carry the core himself. Even if doing so would expose him to its unhealthy aura. If he could rely on Lupino to bring them the core, Renardo would instead assault the Imperial outpost and gain valuable intel for the rebellion. He would also stay away from the core's unhealthy aura.
Lupino,
I think I remember this
rabbit.
Constantly is
Renardo
poisoning me.
You're brave, I know. Renardo
which is going to be hard because I'm pretty low on health already.
Oh, well, at least let me run ahead and warn them you're coming.
Renato wondered if Lupino was up to no good. What if the rabbit warned the Empire instead?
Yeah, that sounds like something he would do.
Betray him like that. Not again. Before it'd been a fluke. Right?
They finished the trip. A happenstance. An unexpected consequence of being a scumbag.
Betray him, or not to. His old friend deserved another chance to prove true.
All right.
Maybe he's changed his ways. Maybe he's not a horrible defector. A traitor, if you may. Ah, finally, going to go see the nerds. Avoided them with the Iblis Stone and with the Sky Ripper and ended up not getting any information on either of them. So, try it a little bit differently this time and see if can get some truth about the Sky Ripper or the, well, not the Iblis Stone.
As Renato watched Lupino vanish on the horizon, he could feel nausea building in him. He felt ill.
So I'm going to have to try and move fast, because
really
is it going to stop at a certain point, or... Okay, it's going to lock me down to 30, no matter what.
A recipe for disaster.
Great. Which is pretty much two hits done in a fight, which kind of sucks.
If they didn't want their things broken, they really ought to make them stronger.
Or not so breakably sweet. It's like a face you just can't help but punch. Ooh, so pretty. Look at all the crystals. A little bit of extra health would be kind of nice, but I think counterproductive for, well, with this poison that's inflicting my body here. Ah. Ice door. Actually,
the pathway made Renato curious.
If I take that, that'll teleport me back to the beginning, but I do want that chest since it's right there, but that grapple point's too far away. With 7 ore, it could make the big difference. No, not really. That, and I think I've run across a workbench since I've gotten the 100 ore. I completely forgot about that. Let's take you. You'll bring me right back here. Then I can take that elevator, wherever the heck that leads.
Yanking his own chain. Wasn't he?
Oh, I've said worse jokes, but man, they must have been going through the catalog of joke dads. Joke Dad Monthly. They'll be getting some of these. They are, pristine in the bad joke levels. The dad joke. So did I just circumvent a majority of the level by taking that pathway and that elevator here because it's a spiraling staircase? No? Maybe? Using the wrong sword, I realized. I have the, damn it! Fuck! I saw him coming at the last moment, and I realize I have the ice sword on, still, not the fire sword. Fire sword would make this a lot easier. Okay, we need to calm down with people coming through all the flames. All the visual effects going on here, I can't tell who's coming after me. See, level 2 sword. Made a lot quicker work of that. That and the fact that they got me up. Physical resistance.
He could feel its secret power.
That sounds nice. Come on now. Face the proper direction. Attaboy, good Renardo. Read this as my health goes down. At school, we learn the gospel of the Transcendent Emperor, the last divinity to pierce the skies. He would banish the evil old gods and grant us the gift of time. But could one man, divine as he may be, create something as intricate as time? I have my own theory. I believe that time is a symphony rather than a gift. I'm convinced that on a cosmic scale, there's a pendulum motion between order and chaos. The Transcendent Emperor ended chaos and started the age we live in, an age of cause and effect, of fact and logic. Time is merely the tapestry upon which these laws manifest themselves. It is the foundation for order's companion, entropy. But in the age of chaos, when the old gods reign, perception carries more weight than facts. Emotions can shape the world, and time ceases to exist. The age of order is ending. I am merely helping the inevitable. Entropy has been broken. Fate has been breached. The end of time is coming, and I shall embrace it. Emperor Ingrim III, the Third, Secret Journal. You sound like a madman. What I just read there seems like the ravings of a madman. What do I know, right? I'm just some fox. Wait, has there been situations where I could backtrack and I just assumed I couldn't because I couldn't see what I was trying to grapple onto? So that was entirely a optional pathway. Like, both of those, not just like an alternative route. Those led me all the way back to the main path. Interesting. Yep, big fight coming up here. One hit, and I'll be down, so. Need to watch for dudes with exclamations. Oh, he almost got me. Woo-wee. Man, that would have been nice if it refilled my health when I leveled up, but no, of course it won't. Yeah, playing on hard mode right now. Having to make sure worse. I don't take a single damn hit.
All his joints were aching now. He'd been through beatings that felt better than this.
Yeah, poison. Poison real bad for you.
Kind of poison that could harm you without even touching you.
Radiation.
Well, it had power. The rebellion needed something with power. And how was this any worse than a sword wound? Well, a death by sword was sudden and fair. This was just squalid. A piecemeal death, like old age.
Hey, come on now. Don't need to. Ooh. Okay, then. I'm not going to question the fact that the environment has not loaded in right here, and just keep playing on and hope that the next environment does load.
And what had Renardo accomplished? He'd rescued Lupino, but ignored his plan. Okay. Now he was dying of the cause of poison.
All right, video game, you're making this incredibly
Take
difficult.
Leave of faith, said the inscription.
Ho. Oh. Wow. That's a hell of a bug. Just a lot of the environment decided not to load in. Cool. Fuck. Wow, I thought that would have killed me. I thought that would have been it. It was locked in the animation. I could not escape. No, don't. Oh, don't you get me. Well, at least this environment exists and works.
Now you spell even worse.
Fuck, I don't know what got me with that, if it was the guy attacking from behind, or if it was the Firebird. One of those, That Firebird, though, gotta love it. Oh, man. Thank you for giving me 100 health, game, when you restarted me on this. I won't get my 300 XP bonus, but I managed to take two hits because this is sloppy. And two guys coming at me from either end. Jeez. Whew. Huh. And then the detrimental effects of the Sky Ripper core continue on. Try to get through this as quickly. Give it to the scientists and I can move on. And I think I end up giving it to them or I have the option. I think I'll leave it with them, perhaps. I don't know. They might not be able to protect it. If it's something like that, I'd have to get into a situation where I might have to destroy it. Just so it doesn't fall into the Emperor's hands. Doesn't fall into the Empire's hands. Oh.
He was pretty sure he'd find something useful in one of these things.
These look like the scientists. This looks like the place I was bringing the core to get sorted out, and it looks like everybody's dead.
The observatory was a burning hulk. Dead scientists everywhere. Bernardo found the mad rabbit cowering under a desk.
Lupino.
The ravens. They must have known we were coming, said Lupino.
Yeah, I wonder how they knew that.
How did you...
Yeah.
See, I was doing a card trick with my lucky deck, and I kind of bobbled the card, so I went under the desk to gather them up, and boom! I guess we'll have to take the car straight to the secret base.
Well,
I wasn't sure he believed that.
No.
But Lupino was talking so fast. He always seemed to make sense.
He's just really incredibly good at lying.
Yes. They had engineers there. But wait. Calaveras. The sage in the mountains. Maybe he would know what to do with the naked core.
Alright, I guess we're stuck with the core for just a bit longer. Let's go check out Calaveras this time. But there was one more scientist. Calaveras was the expert of the Sky Ripper, but did he have the necessary equipment alone out there in the mountains? Renardo could still bring the core to the rebel base. The engineers there would tinker something, hopefully, before he dies from the core's poisoning. No, we've tried the rebels a few times. Let's try to take the scientific approach here. Let's let Calaveras take a look at it. Tried to let the scientists figure it out, but they're all dead now. Thanks, Lupino.
If anyone knew how to assemble the Sky Ripper, Calaveras did. If anyone could heal Renardo and render the core safe, at least to its bearer, surely it was he.
You would hope. But it almost seems like it's a bit of a fool's errand. It seems like not going to turn out the way that was hoping and expecting it to. Like a majority of the things that we've been doing here. We're going to end up dead again, but...
safe place for a landing.
Hmm.
You would have to continue on foot. Muscles aching. Calaveras was a scholar, not a doctor. Could he really save Renardo from the poison radiating from the lost god's eye he was so recklessly carrying?
One could only hope, but hope is all that we really have left to grasp onto in this situation.
What were these poles exactly? Oh, this was not a fun way to die.
No.
Even if he survived.
Slowly.
No one would write balance about a fox whose knees ached forever, would they? Not unless he paid for it.
Just giving me nothing.
For publicity.
At least I got chess. Oh, hey, 10 health. That's going to be gone before I even get into the next group of enemies. maybe. Ah, I spoke too soon. Oh. That was a simple fight. Excellent.
It was chilling walking through the living mountains. There was always noise up ahead. Insects, birds, the croak and flutter of ravens arranging ambushes. But close by, there was only the breeze and the trickle of melting snow. As if every living thing was holding its breath for his poisonous burden to move on. Stay there. I'll go get the marshmallows.
That burning ability is so damn good. It just messes these dudes up. Doesn't even give them a time to breathe. And it seems like these ravens are incredibly weak right now. I don't know why. They seem to be going down very, very easily. And I appreciate that. It's a nice change. So, get the void blade here. Progress along.
Had that door been open before?
Are we not in a very long time? Make sure I got my level 2 blade out, just in case such a thing like this happens. Ooh, shit, that guy was coming at me like I owed him money. Damn it! Oh, at least the checkpoint system in this game is incredibly forgiving. Like, puts me right here, gives me... Yeah, well, you guys are tough. Foxed. Yeah, foxed. Health, and some energy. Physical resistance, level 2. May have to swap that out with crit strikes. Maybe. I don't know. Hello? Chests that I managed to miss before? As I'm slowly dying. Hey! That's not cool. Energy falling through the geometry of the world and going off into the abyss. I need you.
Say, how do you guys fix for life insurance?
Ha! Take that. Oh, shit. Okay, a couple of you guys coming at me. As I said, I can take 2, but I can't handle 3 at a time. Wait, is there more? Where did those other guys come from, and why did I not get any experience out of that last fight? Game's falling apart at the seams as I play it. Cool. Well, at least it looks pretty. PC gaming. Shattering icicles, hoping for something, getting nothing but creating tons of particles. At least they smash up nice. It's kind of cool. Nothing? Just dropping... Wow, was that 1% boost I was getting actually by giving me something?
Platforms were so expensive, they'd run out of budget for guardrails.
Yeah, I'm gonna start stomp smashing those then. Plus, I think I'm doing quite well for ores. Like, I'm gonna be maxed out with ores over the next, I think I only need 70? Or I think I was at 126, that put me at 74. So I can stop going after every little breakable object and just focus on...
What's the point of this gate? Did they think no one would notice the lever?
Oh yeah, I needed that to close that up.
Time was running out for the rebellion. They might already be fighting the Imperial fleet.
I suppose this is the first time I've traversed this map.
To turn an exiled god's eye into something deadly.
No fights for a while either. No alternate pathways. Oh, of course, the first ones I come across after a little bit give me something. Like, even giving me energy would be nice, just because I really love that flame ability, if you're not going to give me health.
Really like the sound his sword made in the air.
That means I can finally get a little bit more stamina. Got 3 charges now. Calaveras! How goes it, old man?
Splendid! Croaked Calaveras. Where's the armature?
Right, I was kind of hoping you wouldn't need it.
No, I don't. It's just a professional interest. We've got much better prismatics than the old TE ever did.
So Calaveras was an arcane engineer. He fussed at the core all day.
And you cured my cancer that I got from the damn thing, right?
In front of it. He placed a huge, round ruby so that it looked like a monstrous, floating eye. So, what is it?
It's better than the old armature?
It's my very first death ray.
What?
And... It won't poison me.
No. It's completely safe now.
Although you're going to die a horrible death because of the exposure you had from before.
Any mirrors.
As he loaded the oculum onto the Farfarer, Bernardo was a little concerned about Calaveras. People who were utterly sure of themselves, he had found, were either experts or horribly wrong. Or both.
Experts at being horribly wrong?
The oculum once.
Sounds like an apt description of me. That sounds like my biography. Expert at being horribly wrong.
And the war was over. Bernardo plunged into the Imperial fleet. He felt the oculum humming. He no longer felt sick. This was gonna be fun. Or at least, it was going to be over.
So we've gotten through the tough part of the exposure to the core. Now we have the oculum. I completely even forgot that the oculum was a thing. I don't know if it's like the Sky River that floats around you and wipes out enemies with just 100% pure prejudice. I guess I'll find out in a second when we get a look at Renardo.
Resisted the temptation.
Yes, look at the oculum. You're pretty.
Sense its arcane energies, yearning to escape the sage's wrappings. But it wasn't eating him alive. So that was a plus. He felt good about himself. He'd saved a friend, he'd helped the rebels, he'd relied on himself, but he'd listened to others. He felt like the right sort of hero. Wise, yet decisive. Calaveras had been so sure it would work. Maybe he could fire it just a few times. No harm in that, right? But only when he absolutely needed to.
Yes, of course. Never, like, frivolously, or to shoot cans off of a fence or something like that. No. We would only use this death ray, as he called it, when it was the most apt, in times of desperation.
Now the road less traveled, thought Renardo. How intriguing.
Give me something. Damn you. Give me sympathy. I don't know. Just give me some health, for God's sakes. Ooh, an elemental resistance. Cool. I guess we're gonna just skip through the level again and take the boats. Yeah, we're right into the fleet already. That didn't take long. As who the heck was it?
Break.
Verizon? That was easy? Nope. Can't remember who the heck the tagline that was. Staples. Well, that was easy.
Ah, Renardo's arm was getting tired. The core was no longer eating at him, but he still felt weak. His stamina was shot. But he had the oculum. When the ravens swarmed him, it would sometimes fire its death ray. It seemed to be warming up, too, firing more and more often. Maybe he should let it cool off. Yeah, he decided to stop using it entirely.
I don't know, haven't seen the oculum do anything quite. God damn it! Stop hitting me! These guys are all boosted. Jesus. Is that supposed to have physical resistance on that? I got hit twice and it took me down to 5 health. I guess I would have died if not. Or maybe I got hit more than twice. Either way, that oculum did absolutely nothing in that fight. Going back to a Fireblade. I like watching people burn. Wow, killed everybody else but left you guys laying about. You ain't gonna buff each other, I don't think. And if you are, well, still waiting for that oculum to take a shot.
One of these things.
I think.
Oh, that would be amazing. Yeah. It would be like having a boat.
A boat, but it's a ship. It's like a boat ship. Or a sky ship. Oh, this is going to be an interesting fight. But it's not going to be a fight. Okay, cool. Always forget about that. I always think that I can head off to... I probably did when I had the Sky Ripper. I did take that left path and end up on that ship there that opened up that big bird mouth. But now with the oculum, we going different. We running different, son. Gonna keep an eye on you, Shield Bearer. You guys are tough. Seems like these guys are stronger. There we go. Keep focused on certain ones and... Wow, 48 combo. Jesus, I guess I was just laying into dudes and they weren't dying. Ah, the Emperor.
The oculum was still hot to the touch. He almost thought it was getting even hotter. That was ridiculous, of course.
Yeah, I showed up with a completely different weapon this time.
He only fired it one more time, and then he could chuck the whole contraption into the abyss.
and the Emperor's ship was now in range. Renardo squinted. He could make out the line of ravens protecting the ship. Zenobia in front, conjuring. And on the deck, yes, that was His Imperial Majesty, pacing in his golden armor. Renardo lined up his shot.
Golden armor?
And fired.
Wow.
Caught in the beam, the ship burst into flames. The ravens and Zenobia exploded.
Holy shit.
The Emperor too exploded.
So we won.
Renardo waited for the beam to stop. But it only got brighter, and the oculum hotter.
Uh-oh.